Ahmed Alhan Mohammed. Ahmed Michelle Nasir. Ahmed Tahseen Amir. Aishat Isra Abdullah. Aminath Nashwa Nasir. Asha Ahmed Samir. Ashwa Ahmed Nasir. Fatima Zuhra Ismail. Suhani De Elvis. Matat Ibrahim Shujao. Muhammad Khalis Abdul Khalil. Muhammad Mawiz Abdullah. Nadir Aman. Rick Sadil Jalil. Shasha Muhammad Ibrahim. Sujoy Batre. Vifag Ibrahim Adnan. Yaish Nasim. Zain Hamid. Zuleha Shiura Yusuf. Thank you, madam. Thank you, sir.
Mr. Misbah, congratulations to all of those who have received certificates. Our chief guest, Madam Fatmat Amira, will now address you. Please welcome her to the stage.
Thank you. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. The Chairman of Islanders Education, Mr. Abdul Rashid, Vice Principals, Principal, Senior Management, and other staff of the school, parents, well-wishers, and my dear students. Assalamu alaikum and a very good evening. Now, I wish to express my sincere gratitude to the principal and the chairman of Island Education and senior management and the students for giving me this opportunity to grace this function of your day of recognition. It is indeed a pleasure and privilege to meet the students of Billabong School for the first time and say a few words. First of all, let me congratulate the students who have achieved good results on their checkpoint exams and the winners of 2014 scholarships. I would also like to congratulate the teachers who did well in the CICTT. I'm pleased that you have worked really hard and achieved these results and scholarships. I would say that it is a very good start that you have made on a long journey to fulfill your ambitions and dreams. So please keep working hard to achieve your goals. Let me also express my sincere appreciation to your principals, teachers, and parents who must have contributed immensely for your success. Their tremendous support will always be remembered with gratitude. This is my first visit to Billabong School after it became Billabong High International. I must say that I'm very much surprised and amazed by the immense facilities that you have available here in this school in comparison to other schools of the Maldives. I think the students in Billabong are very lucky, and the progress that you have been making in academics as well as sports and other extracurricular activities is really a recognition worth recognizing, and I think it is a symbol of the school's good performance. I will not take much of your time, especially on a Thursday night, but I would like to highlight, since I'm here, a few points that would perhaps be of some guidance to you in your journeys for success. When we get invited to address students, we think about what to say, and there are so many things that can be said to students of your age. I was thinking to myself, what should I tell these students? I thought I would just highlight on a few points in relation to what's happening around us these days. We have been giving good advice and guidance, especially your principal and teachers must have been doing an excellent job for you to achieve these results. And I'm sure there wouldn't have been anything of advice and guidance that wouldn't have been said. But let's start from the basics. I mean, we need to remind each other at times when the world is changing of some main basic principles that are going out of hand. The first point that I would like to note is making the best use of time. By this, I do not mean you should always be engaged in studies. You need to always have in mind that time is very precious. In fact, that's the most precious thing that we have. So you need to plan your time and ensure that your time is best utilized to achieve your overall development in all areas. This includes doing all your schoolwork and revision, as well as religious duties, extracurricular activities, developing your leadership skills, socializing with your friends, visit relatives and friends, assist your parents and everyone else in the house, do housework, and learn different types of work as much as possible. So the time has to be allocated evenly to develop all these things that happens in your environment. What we do not want to see happen today is the youngsters chatting on the Facebook and other social media for most of their time. Is this what is happening today? Some of you all are nodding, yes. But keep in mind, this is the very reason why I pointed out this point, you know. Keep in mind that time is precious, and of course you need to be chatting and making friends. That's also a part of socializing. But this is becoming more common now. If we have the sitting room with the family, they are all in the internet or with their phones, you know, everybody pressing their buttons. So let's try to change this a little bit and allocate some amount of time for that as well. Not so much time. The second thing that I wanted to highlight here is about a career. I know that Billabong is doing a very good job by exposing you to different subjects up until the 10th grade. That is very essential. In fact, what we have in other schools, in most of the other schools, is not really the best. You are lucky to have the best available opportunities and all the subjects given to you all at lower secondary level. That gives you an exposure of the subjects and allows you to think wider when you make your career choices. But it's important that you do make a career choice, because when you do, you tend to work hard to achieve that career. For example, students who might want to do medicine, if you are not decided by the end of the 10th or the 12th grade whether you want to do medicine or not, you wouldn't have chosen the right subjects which might be required to do medicine. And you wouldn't have worked hard enough to get a place in a good university in the subjects that you are expected to do as prerequisites. So it's important that you think about what you don't have to decide definitely, but think about and keep searching on the internet and maybe perhaps get counseling from the relevant people, depending on the skills that you have, to decide on what is best for you. We have some students, after finishing school, they still sit at home, not knowing what to do. And when we apply for scholarships or loans, they would apply for one area first and then write a few days later to change the area. So this is the position right now. So I think you need to do good research and keep thinking about this. This is something to think about. The other thing that I thought I would mention is about your flexible work environments. Now, work environments is a little far away from you all because you are still in lower secondary, most of you. But at one point, you will get to work when you finish school immediately, or some of you maybe after doing further studies. Now, at that point, sometimes, depending on where you are in the world, you may not be able to get exactly a job to do the work that you have been trained for. For example, if you get trained as a lawyer, you may not immediately get a lawyer's position to go to court and practice law. But you might get a place, maybe to teach law or whatever else that is relevant to that. What I'm trying to say is be ready to take up what comes first instead of choosing and waiting, wasting time. That's very important. And nowadays we have to, and we see what's happening in the world, is people change careers about 3-4 times during their lifetime. So even if you get trained to do certain work, like lawyers or any other field of study, you may still have to change what you are trained to do depending on what's available. Fourthly, I would like to mention about making yourselves a very useful person for your family and the society. This is also one thing that, you know, is fading away slowly. We see students not doing enough, work at home, maybe helping your moms and dads, and doing your share of the work at home, cleaning, tidying place, maybe your own room or other premises in the house, is very essential. That you devote some time to help your family, friends, and make sure that you leave your quarter of the time for that. Try to volunteer and engage yourself also in voluntary work in school too. You don't always have to be a prefect to take the initiative to do things. You can take the initiative and volunteer to help, and then slowly your principals and teachers will realize your leadership strengths. I think that is one way of proving your leadership in schools as well. With the permission of the expected staff, students, and parents, I would like to say a few words in Divahi on behalf of the parents. The Algon Miremi, which Ali Aluwali Hatar Nugutaya Gewahaka Divahi Bombes Dannawalana, Emma Furthama Algon Fahakoli Kamaki, Wagutuke Benung Emma Furihame Kurung, Miharakang As Algon Mena Fenne Eru, Vara Gina Fahara Kudin. Kudinnya nombade ti mihom vesama, varak boda Facebook a adi social media a varak gina wagutta heda koramunde. Adi eni heng kangkamu kaves. Ehem vima kudinna alugandu miding nasihataki. Ekudinge wagutu eme furihama gotuka bahala agen. Eki kangkama wagutu heda korum. Misalaka ekudinge ituru harakatto ga baverum kievum. Namaduko adi eheni hen dini wajitta ada kurun adi ekudinge leadership varuga daana fada harakatta oka baverivum kudinna adi belen verinna adi rattinna ek wagut hedako ekudinna ki sociable bayage gotuka bodwam fursat dinum